war in Ukraine has shown that drones are crucial in a modern battlefield, and it's clear that they'll play an even more important role in the future. The U.S. military has achieved a significant milestone in this regard. The USS George H.W. Bush, CVN 77, a U.S. supercarrier, has become the first aircraft carrier in the world to establish a dedicated Unmanned Air Warfare Center, UAWC. Setting the stage for the deployment of the cutting-edge MQ-25 Stingray drone. In a press release dated August 15th, the Naval Air Systems Command, NAVAIR, announced that the U.S. Navy recently installed the world's first Unmanned Air Warfare Center, UAWC, aboard the Nimitz-class aircraft carrier. This new center will enable air vehicle pilots, or AVPs, to control future airborne operations of the MQ-25 Stingray. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the UAW Center in USS George H.W. Bush paves the way for the MQ-25 Stingray. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The press statement highlighted that the installation took several years to complete, aligning with the ship's deployment timeline and availability. However, the command did not specify the exact date of the installation. NAVAIR stated, "The CVN-based control room, known as the UAWC, includes software and hardware systems that comprise the first fully operational and integrated Unmanned Carrier Aviation Missile Control System, UMCS, MD-5E Ground Control Station, GCS. It explained that the UMCS is a critical system of systems required for the command and control of the MQ-25 aerial vehicle, essential for the operation of the unmanned aerial refueler. Unmanned Carrier Aviation, PMA-268, Program Manager, Captain Daniel Fusito, was quoted in the press release saying, "CVN-77's UAWC lays the groundwork for how the U.S. Navy will operate and control unmanned aircraft and potentially other unmanned vehicles using UMCS." Providing further details, he added, "These systems will initially support the MQ-25, but are also designed to accommodate future unmanned systems, such as collaborative combat aircraft, which will be part of the air wing of the future." NAVAIR also released a photo showing two operator stations equipped with numerous monitors, tablet-like devices, and other advanced computer technology. This control hub will be used to operate the Navy's future unmanned aerial refueling vehicle, the MQ-25 Stingray. The Multi-Domain Combat System, MDCX, which powers the Ground Control Station, GCS, was developed by Lockheed Martin's Skunk Works. The USS George H.W. Bush will test the UAWC's networks at sea early next year to verify these systems' functionality. During a training exercise, air vehicle pilots, AVPs, from Unmanned Carrier-Launched Multi-Role Squadron, VUQ-10, will take control and use the GCS to manage simulated air vehicles. Joe Nadeau, PMA-268 UMCS lead, said, "The upcoming tests will be a historic moment for naval aviation. For the first time, AVPs will control unmanned aircraft from an aircraft carrier, marking a significant leap in our operational capabilities." Boeing MQ-25 Stingray is an aerial refueling drone that resulted from the Carrier-Based Aerial Refueling System, or CBARS, program. The primary role of the Stingray drones will be to provide crucial aerial refueling support to the Navy's carrier air wings. A Additionally, these drones possess the capability to operate in a secondary role, undertaking intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance missions as needed. In October 2017, the U.S. Navy released the final MQ-25 Stingray RFP. The Navy's goal for the aircraft is to be able to deliver 15,000 pounds or 6,800 kilograms of fuel total to 4 to 6 airplanes at a range of 930 kilometers or 580 miles. The competitors were Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, General Atomics, and Boeing. Lockheed Martin put on the table their Sea Ghost design based on the RQ-170 Sentinel. Northrop Grumman initially proposed X-47B but later withdrew, stating it wouldn't be able to execute the program under the terms of the service's request for proposals. General Atomics proposed the Sea Avenger concept, which is an enlarged version of the Avenger drone customized for air refueling. Boeing came into the competition with a full-fledged prototype derived from its Phantom Ray demonstrator, which ultimately won. The design is powered by a single Rolls-Royce AE-3007N turbofan engine that delivers 10,000 pounds or 4,500 kilograms of thrust. Over the years, Boeing has been engaged in extensive testing of the MQ-25 demonstrator, referred to as T-1, bearing the U.S. Civil Registration Code N-234MQ. Three major aircraft, including the F-A-18 Super Hornet, an E-2D Advanced Hawkeye, and an F-35C Lightning II, have been refueled by the MQ-25T1 test asset. These tests form a crucial part of Boeing's ongoing efforts to develop the initial production representative prototypes of the Stingray for the U.S. Navy. It's expected that MQ-25 will reach initial operational capability sometime in 2026. The setting up of the UAV Center further suggests that the MQ-25 Stingray may finally be deployed aboard the carrier soon. The development signals a future where unmanned systems will come to the forefront. The successful installation aboard CVN-77 sets a precedent for future carriers, with plans to implement similar systems on other vessels. Eventually, this system will be integrated into all Nimitz-class carriers, as well as the new Ford-class aircraft carriers. The contract is worth $13 billion, as around 72 such drones will be inducted in total. A budget allocation of $553 million has been made for 3 aircraft in fiscal 2025. The manufacturer of MQ-25, Boeing, is already looking at adding more capability to the UAV besides refueling. In April this year, it unveiled a revolutionary design for the MQ-25, featuring a version equipped with 2 Lockheed Martin long-range anti-surface missiles, or LRASM. While this is just a concept as of now, this represents a significant shift from the drone's original role as an aerial refueler, suggesting its potential to perform a variety of missions, including surveillance and targeted strikes against enemy assets. It's evident that the UAW Center has been established at the right time, and the U.S. Navy, especially its supercarriers, will be well-placed in terms of drone warfare in the coming days.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.